Hello Eagles, I'm Stephen and welcome to another TS 2016 review. Today we are going to be looking at a DLC that has been out, can you believe it, for over a year now. I can't believe it myself. But we're going to be looking at a DLC that's been out for over a year, has had a slight update, and that is the lovely 1400s. Yes, I mean, come on, how can we not? The 1400s are by far the best Great Western tank engine ever built, and if anyone disagrees with me, then... well, you're just wrong. The 1400s have been out for over a year, and Steam Sound Supreme have made brand new sound packs for it. So this is a review of not only the 1400s, but also the sound pack as well. So you get a bit of a combo in this one. Special treat for you all. But also, some of you keen viewers are going, hold on a minute, not seen this one before. Well, no, obviously, because this BR Line Brunswick 1400 is only available with the Steam Sound Supreme sound pack. So if you buy the sound pack for the 1400 pack, you will get this livery. And I believe they've also done some slight sound modifications to the auto coaches, but who really cares about that? I mean, we're all here for the locos, right? Seriously, we're all here for the locos, right? Please tell me we are. I have a choice here of two 1400s, before I get onto that, the original 1400 pack comes with a variety of different liveries. You've got this one here, which is the 4800. The original classification of these was the 4800s, but because of later builds of Great Western Locomotive classes, they then rebranded the 4800s to the 1400s. So this pack, the original pack, comes with this one, the Great Western livery. It comes with the BR Black livery, for the 1400, and it also comes with the 5800s, which are exactly the same as the 48/1400s, except that the 5800s were never auto fitted. So you get the 1400s in Great Western Green and BR Black, and you can get the 5800s also in Great Western Green and in BR Black, unlined black, I might add. This one, as I said earlier, in the Steam Sound Supreme sound pack. Now, decision here. Oh, hold on, let me just have a quick drink. Ah, Bisto. So I got a choice here of two locos. Either Seven Valley or Didcot. Seven Valley, Didcot. Seven Valley, Didcot. Titfield, baby! I mean, yes, come on, how can we not? If we're doing a 1400 review, we've got to have this old girl in. We have to. It's the law. It's the law. Whenever you think of a 1400, you think of 1401. Anyone that doesn't, you're a fool. So, let's hop in. Safety valve's already pissing its nuts off. The cab vent, just up there. Ooh. Up here, do I have a mouse in there? Right, so, oh yeah, these open as well. Let's start talking about the logo. The cab windows open very nicely, the little portals there. These are little sliders, the little shutters, open and close as well. They slide backwards and forwards. And if you go into the exterior view, look at that, it actually blanks it off. That is so cool. Really, 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 really nice. And slide that back over. The cab detail is very, very nice. The back of the cab here opens. Ooh, very nice, very nice. Open to... oh, there's no central view. Oh my god. What the hell? Why have I suddenly shrunk? I've become the borrowers! Yeah, the cab is really, really beautifully detailed. In fact, I'll tell you what. Let's shut that. Just have a bit more shade. It is sunny outside. So, if we can get the road... oi! Come on. Give us the road. Give us the road. You're not going to give us the road, are you? Okay, so we got the road at last. Let's get going then. So, actually, let's start off by going, because this is a review, and I'm not really talking about much of a review. I mean, it's got... oh, look at the... it's a bucket. I got a bucket on my 14... are you moving? Are you... excuse me? You are not going without me, Titfield. I mean, I know you want to run over the steamroller again. I mean, wait for me, though. Oh, do not be telling me I'm going to be fighting with you over the safety valves like I did with the DRBR86. There's a bucket and a shovel thing at the back. The textures are really, really nice. I like it out of the fact that all the 1400s seem to have the... Oh, if my mic has picked that up. Oh, my God. Facebook! I like it how all the 1400s have exactly the same shed code. Which don't bother me none. It don't bother me at all. And let's have a... If there's one thing I like the Victory Works products, is that the fact that there is actually detail. In fact, here's a true fact. Someone said to me, I think it was in the K1 video, that the textures from Victory Works, that the way that Victory Works has done the textures on the models, is a bit bland and like too glossy. And there's not really much baked texture, as it were, like you see on some of the other developers' models. And to be quite honest, I like that look from Victory Works. I like it. I really, really do like it. But hey, that's just my personal preference. I mean, after all, it is my opinion, after all. Let's have a look inside the... Oh, I love the fact that the motion in here actually works. Like when you're going along and you're looking outside in the exterior view. Ah! I can see into the... I can see to the bricks. I like the fact that as you're going along, you can actually see like the con rods and the crankshaft just moving. It is just the most fantastic sight on this engine. Absolutely love this model. Absolutely love it as a pack. Right, so F5 up because we don't. I mean, who needs the F? Who needs the F4 up? I mean, come on. Who wants the Tonka toy up? Who wants the Tonka toy up? No one. We have the road still and. Away we do go. Roll on, my beauty. And straight away, the chuffs are immediately better. Very, very nice. I do like the chuffs. Open the regulator up a bit more. Off, 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 off. Ooh, that was actually quite a nice view. Come on, girl. Off, 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 off. And Cindercock's close. Oh, here we go now. Here we go with the chuffs. Now, the one thing I'm sure everyone wants to know is, what are the sounds like when you're cruising at like the 25 mile an hour speed? Because in the original pack, the sounds were all right. The sounds were fine, but the chuff loop into sort of like when it gets to like 18, 20 miles an hour up until the sort of like 35 to 38 was a bit dodgy. But hey, that actually didn't really bother me none. I mean, oh. Now, I don't know whether you can hear that, but immediately, as soon as it hit to 20 miles an hour, it was... Oh, that chuff sound is so much better. Oh, wind you down a bit. Crack up the regulator a bit more. Come on, girl, let me hear you sing! Oh, wow, that is a beautiful beat. Oh, I'm liking this a lot. Oh, and close the regulator, because there's a very, 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 very sharp curve on this route. Oh, you can see the conrod movement underneath. Ah. Have I told anyone how I really love Victory Works? Have I? No? Well, I do. I can watch that all day, just the motion on the inside. It's so beautifully scripted and animated. Ah, oh, that's so pretty. Chuffing along, am I looking at my jib? Chuff, 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 chuff. Now, I wonder what the Was it control space for the low tone whistle? Eh? I'm sure it was. Yeah, it was, so... Eh? What? Okay. Matt, from Steam Town Supreme, if you're watching this, the low tone secondary whistle doesn't work. The particles are there like they should do, like on the original pack, but it's, yeah, something's... There should be sound there. So, hold on a minute. If the secretary... Hold on, let's have a look at the main... Let's have a look. Let's have a listen to the new whistle, the new space bar whistle. Ugh. Oh, I don't really much like that looping. There, muted the bugger. Oh. Don't really much like that looping. The chuffs I really like. I really like the chuffs. But the... To be really quite honest, I actually prefer the original whistles that came with the 1400 pack. And the fact that the secondary whistle actually works. So hold on a minute. If it's not control space for the secondary whistle, the low tone whistle, like it was normally, where in the hell... Or rather, what in the hell isn't the key for it now? Is it shift space? Oh no, that's the... Hold on a minute! Oh, shift space is the short whistles. Oh, I like them. Oh, damn it. Come on, girl. We need to get you up the hill. Come on, 1400. Come on, Tidfield. Keep rolling, my beauty. We... Oh my god, the bark! Oh my god, that is lovely! Oh, that is so beastly. Oh, sparks flying from the chimney. Come on, girl, come on. Yeah, there we are. We just crested then. Yep. Yeah, we're just crested now. Oh, I really like that beasty chuff. Oh, that is... Can you see why I like the 1400s now? They put you to about there. So, yeah, so that's... So shift space is the short whistle sounds. Which I like, they're nice. That was the same one, twice. Oh! Oh, that was a nice one. Nah, little one. Nah, and again. And then that one. So where's the long... Because look, you definitely got the control space. You definitely got the particles, so it's definitely... That's definitely the original key command when you just get the 1400 pack standalone without the sounds. Without the Steam Sound Supreme sounds. That's definitely key for it, for the low-tone whistle, so... I wonder what... It must be assigned to the wrong button or something, so what would it be? Huh. The secondary low-tone whistle now is now keyed to exactly the same button as the bell command to the auto-coach, which is B. So every time you hit the bell, you get a whistle. couple of marks off for that one, I think.
Oh, God, I really do love the 1400s. It's such a beautiful Great Western tank engine.
And 1401 is the pinnacle of that design. Again, when you think 1400, you think 1401. And only her. Only her. She's the sole reason why I actually love the 1400s. Purely because of that film. Nothing else. God damn that film, I love it so much. That really is a nice beat. I really do like that beat. Oh, gonna be going faster in a minute. Whee! Oh my god, I've just spotted a glitch with the DT, the former DT Mark 1s. What in the... Okay, he was there. We all saw that, right? We all saw that, right? Please say you saw it. Now then, because when we was going up that hill, I actually really liked the chuff sound from it, the really, really vicious bark sounds. I thought, we'll take a slight detour. We'll come off the main line. We'll go on to the little branch line extension I made. And then we'll come out here. And this was about a 1 in 27? So we'll really get to hear her. And I hope we make it, because the last thing I want to do is to stop and be embarrassed by the teddies of the robots. Don't tease me. Stop judging me. They see her ruling. They're fapping. Yeah, I'm really not keen on that whistle. I mean, I'm all for it and happy that it's different, but the looping, I'm not really a fan of. I think after this, I might see if I can change it to the default whistles. I actually like them better than this. Honest to God, I do. I actually really do. Now, we're going slow. Because this is a bit of a steep hill itself, and we're going to be descending into the black hole. So, here we go. On the descent, which is it's a 1 in 35. So it's still pretty steep even for an engine like this. There we go, we're picking up the speed now. Faster, faster, faster. Haven't even got the regulator open yet and we're already doing 28 miles an hour. And into the tunnel we go. Open that up. Oh yes, that is pretty. Oh no, sorry, I said that wrong. Oh, Russ. I can't see a bloody thing outside. I can see the light. I can see the light. I can see the light. Yes. Ah! It burns. Into the doom and gloom we go. Now this one, we got to open her up a bit. Otherwise, we won't make it. A little bit more. Oh, crush. It sounds like a machine gun at 44 miles an hour. I genuinely cannot see apart from the window, so have that open a little bit. Oh yeah, this bit, you watch. 1 in 16, that little gradient there. 1 in 16. Oh, now here we go. 36 miles an hour, that's a really nice chuffing loop. Now, up and over the ski jump. Let's crank you up a bit more. Admit. No, I don't want to save it. Go away. Yeah. Oh, a 1 in 18. Even steeper than I thought. Oh, look at that. We merge up at the top of the hill. At 20 miles an hour, which is just below the 25 limit. Skills, my friend. I really do like the new chuffs on this. Really does enhance the experience with the engine. The short whistle blast I really like. But I'm disappointed that the secondary low tone whistle doesn't work, even though the particles are there for the original scripting, or the original pack. And the fact that the main space bar has a bit of a loop problem. Or audio loop problem, sound effect anyway. Oh, I don't want to save it again, go away. God damn it, I've got a new keyboard because my other one broke, which is why I haven't been uploading any videos as such, because, well, you can't really do anything without a keyboard, can you? Round the curve we go. The coupling is hovering. It's not even with the coaches anymore. Is it doing it to... Oh my God, all of them's doing it. How very, very strange. Ah, what a lovely sight. I think we're going to stop here. And brake. Brakes, God, please. Before we take this girl to the sheds, there's one thing I forgot to say. Just like all the other Victory Works products, you can, by holding down control, then going through numbers 1 to 4, you can put the headlamps on. Control shift? No. I'm sure it was control and then just the numbers. Yeah, it was. God damn this keyboard. There we are, we've got the Royal Train. So, for this, we're going to be going a doop. I said doop. There we are, light engine head code. So, if we now go around the back and go skadoosh. There we are, we've uncoupled. Give us a road, please. Thank you very much. Okay, so we're back at the sheds. As a whole, what do I think of the 1400 pack? Well, a 1400 pack is a very, very, very lovely add-on. Definitely worth getting the money for it. It's available up on Steam. And, oh, hold on a minute, doing this properly. There we are. So yeah, the 1400 pack is very, very, very lovely. Really highly recommend getting it. The Steam Sun Supreme pack, what do I make of that? Well, honestly, I would recommend getting it for the better chuff sounds and the fact that you get a new liveried version of the 1400, and especially, as you can see here, you can actually have 1450 in her current guards of BR Lime Brunswick, so in effect you can have an authentic preserved version of her. But yeah, let's do the scorings of it. The Loco pack as a whole. Loco pack as a whole, I will say this now, I apologise if I didn't go too in-depth with it like I have done with all the other reviews. I'm a bit in a rush. This is a bit like a rush review, so I apologise for that. But The pack as a whole, I definitely would give it 10 out of 10. Absolutely love it. So I recommend picking it up on Steam. The Steam Sun Supreme one, I'm going to give it... I'm actually going to give it an 8 out of 10. Purely because of the fact that the whistles. The high tone one, it's got that weird looping sound on it, which was like a bit off-putting. The control space for the low tone whistle, the particles are there. So it's the same scripting as just like in the original pack, but the audio isn't there, which is a bit disappointing. And the fact that the secondary low tone whistle was actually sharing the same key command as the bell commands for the auto coach, which is going to be very confusing. Bloody hell, my voice broke then, which is going to be very confusing and well a bit annoying for some people, especially if you're in the cab. It's I'd give it a. I'd also give the sound pack a 10 out of 10 if those sort of things were maybe tweaked a little, like the loop of the main space was sorted out, and the fact that there's an actual scripting glitch on Steam Sound Supreme's behalf, and the fact that that obviously the secondary low whistle is obviously scripted and keyed to the wrong place. So, yeah, that's the 1400 review. Sorry, it's not in-depth as all the other ones. Again, I'm a bit rushed for time, so it was literally... I literally got home, start recording it, literally did the review on the fly. So, yeah. The 1400 pack. Really, really worth getting. 10 out of 10. Steam Sound Supreme pack. For me personally, I would get it for the better chuffs and the new Livid 1400. That, for me, is the sole reason why I'd get it. Again, worth getting... But don't get your hopes up about the whistle, as you just saw. If you guys really enjoyed this, please be sure to leave a like. Subscribe for more content if you want to see more. And I'll see you all in the next video. Ta-ra, Yugles.